Inhale and exhale. Feel yourself go even further. Last time, inhale and exhale and down. Now, slowly inhale and stretch the legs out in front of you, flexing the toes. Now, taking the fingertips around the toes, flex the thumbs. Inhale and bringing the elbows down towards the floor, forehead down. Now from here, drawing the chin towards the feet, inhale and exhale all the way down. Repeat, chin forward, towards the feet, stretch and drop the head all the way down. Now relax the hands, relax the feet, and using the tummy muscles, slowly going back down onto the floor. And as you go down, feel that every single muscle in your body will now relax. Relax the toes, relax the ankles, release the knees, the thighs, tummy muscles, relax all the internal organs. Breathing deeply through the nose from the diaphragm, concentrating on the breath. Now moving the fingertips, just relax the hands, relax the wrists, elbows. Now bring the shoulders up towards the ears, up and down. Repeat. Again, inhale up, release all the tension in the neck and shoulders, and down. Now slowly turn your head to the right, very slowly releasing the tension, and coming back up through center, and to the left, and let your head flop wherever it feels like. Relax the neck, breathing deeply, focusing on the breath, you're totally relaxed, the breath becomes very quiet and the mind becomes very still, just hold. Now to release from this pose, turn to the side, bringing the knees into the chest and relax on your side. Kalari is the ancient system of martial arts. We use animals to symbolize the power and strength. This first exercise we're doing is called the horse. Bringing the hands up, keep the tempo and rhythm very smooth and even. It is a very slow and meditative movement which draws the energy into yourself. Try to focus on the hands, relax the wrists, and just let the movement flow. It starts to focus the mind and concentrates the mind and trains you for combat. Using the breath, inhale as the arms go up and exhale as the hands go down. keep the rhythm and movement steady and even. Inhale and exhale. Now focus the eyes straight ahead, turning the body focus straight ahead. And now coming back to center, we'll move from side to side. Focus straight ahead. Know exactly the point that you're going from and to. And up and over. Spine stays totally straight and erect. And feet together. Now, the next pose we're going to do is called the elephant. It's a very strong and powerful movement. Take the feet in a second position and bend the knees right over the toes, wide. Keep the weight right in between the legs. Taking the arms in front of you, palms together, elbows together, take the arms up over the head, close to the ears. Hold. Now bringing the elbows together, imagine that it's a trunk of an elephant, taking your arms behind you and then in a circle, bringing the elbows together. Hold. Take the right arm out, swing it under the other arm, bring the palms together and increase the stretch. And release and relax. Now let's try the other side. So again, bend and make sure your knees do not overextend the toes. Elbows together, palms together. And stretch the arms overhead. Now bringing the elbows in, taking it along the line of the body, taking the arms through and back, swing around with the elbows in front of you, then take the left arm out, swing it under, palms together, and increase the bend, and release, and relax. Now, the next exercise we're going to do is called the lion, and you'll see from the movement that it is a combat position, really a self-defense position. Take the right arm over the left and curving the body slightly to the left. Now step in front of you, bend that knee and take the leg through and bend. So the leg in front is bent and the leg behind you is straight. And curve the body from side to side. Now stepping back, continue the movement and bend the front knee and stretch the arms and back. Now we repeat the whole series in a faster pace. And back, and back, and back, and back. And feet together, and relax. The kicks are very important in combat training. Shows the strength and the skill and the balance of the warrior. It's still very graceful, but very powerful. The mind and the body is working together. and total coordination. And again, quicken the pace, sharpen the kick. Kick and kick and circles are very important in combat to have agility and quickness of movement. We're first going to do circles just to mark the positions. So stretching to the side, make sure the weight is in between the legs. To the side and around and back to center. Now we're going to add the arms. So as you go out, push the arms outward and bring the palms into the chest. Push the palms out and into the chest with the hands and center. Let's go the other way. Stretch and push. Palms down into the chest. Turn and push. And hands down into the chest and back to center. And release. Now coming down onto the mat, taking the fingertips right under the shoulder blades and point the toes behind you. This is the cobra pose that increases flexibility of the spine. Inhale, bringing the elbows into the body, raising upwards, looking as far up as you can. Hold. And slowly down. Now we're going to repeat the exercise. Now bringing the palms to face each other, elbows outwards. Now push the palms down and really stretching up to your maximum. Stretch. This is a wonderful exercise for people who suffer from back pain. And release. It strengthens all the muscles in the lower back. Push again, inhale, and stretch all the way back, and release, and relax all the way down. Now taking your hands under the shoulder blades again, push the palms down and bring the hips all the way back to the heels to stretch out the spine. Stretch. And release and coming up. Now let's go on to the back. Legs out in front of you. We're going to stretch the hip area out. Now taking the right knee into the chest, take the knee towards the shoulder. Feel the stretch and release and lower. Other side, bring the knee in and gently take the knee towards the shoulder to maximize the stretch. And release and down. Now bringing both knees into the chest, taking a hold of the elbows. Stretch both knees down into the chest and raise your chin upwards. Stretch. Now lower the arms to the floor. Push the palms down and take the legs over the head into the plow position. Support the small of the back with your hands. Now breathing deeply. Your chin is locked into the chest. This regulates your metabolism and your hormone levels, as well as the thyroid. Hold deeply. Now slowly coming down, pushing each and every part of the vertebrae down onto the floor and using your tummy muscles to control the descent all the way down. Keep the shoulders down. Don't lift the head. Now bend the knees. Take the feet down and relax the legs and relax the arms and just breathing deeply. Inhale and exhale. Repeat, inhale and exhale. Now thinking of your tummy muscles, you're going to slowly take the arms out and coming forward and relax onto the legs. And relax forward, forehead down. And sitting tall, we're going to do a wonderful twist. Twists are wonderful to release toxins from the system. Bend the knee, take the heel right in front of the knee. Now take the opposite elbow across, looking over the right shoulder, twist, place the hand down and really twist, looking over that shoulder. Keep twisting. It looks like a very simple exercise and it's extremely effective. And release. Now legs out in front of you. Let's do the opposite side. Make sure that the knee is up and the heel in front and both buttocks muscles are down. Take the opposite arm, then leg, hook it across and look over that left shoulder. Keep twisting, twist, 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 just a little bit more, just a tiny bit more. And release. Now both legs out in front of you, relax forward all the way down. And slowly release and sitting in a comfortable cross-legged position. Sitting up tall, try to get the knees down to the floor. Let's do some breathing techniques that will de-stress the entire nervous system. Inhale and take the head all the way back. And exhale through the mouth and down. Inhale and drop the head all the way back. Relax the jaw. Open the mouth and coming forward. Repeat, inhale with a deeper breath. Inhale. Drop the head back and release through the mouth and forward. Now sitting up tall, we want to release all the tension in the neck and shoulders. Inhale, bring the shoulders all the way up to the ears, up, 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 and down. Repeat, inhale, up. And down. Now let's do head rolls. Bring the chin into the chest and inhale slowly and take your head slowly to the right. Exhale and drop the head all the way back to the left and forward. Now let's continue around with a deep inhalation to the right. Exhale, drop the head back. Inhale, around. And exhale, chin into the chest. Now let's go the other way. Inhale, really moving the neck around. Drop the head back to the left. Exhale, and forward and continue around. Really feel every single part of the neck release with tension. And forward. Now, sitting up tall, taking the thumb and first finger together, taking the three fingers into the palm, stretch the thumb and baby finger, take the baby finger to the left nostril, block the nostril, inhale and exhale only to the right. Very deep and slow. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Repeat. Inhale and exhale. Last time. Inhale deeper and deeper and exhale. Now change, taking the thumb to the nostril and breathing through the left. You can feel the difference between the right and the left. The left is cooler, softer, and represents the feminine principle, where the right side is stronger and the masculine side. Keep breathing. This calms and soothes the brain. And now, breathing through both nostrils, thumb and first finger together, breathing deeply through both, feel the balance and the harmony. Breathing deeper and deeper. The mind becomes very still, trying to push all the thoughts, especially negative thoughts, out of the mind. Keep concentrating only on the breath. Inhale and exhale. Deeper and deeper. Honoring the gods. Putting the teacup between the eyebrows in the middle of the forehead. typical Bollywood move. Lion. The horse. Kick. Hands and head and I really hope you've enjoyed the program. Remember that you have to connect the mind and body to the spiritual self to have a whole, healthy, balanced life. Inner happiness and inner peace comes from proper exercise, deep relaxation, correct breathing, a moderate diet, positive thinking, and spiritual life. We've taken you back to the original roots of yoga and given you physical health, mental balance, and spiritual enlightenment.